Hello there and welcome back. In this video we are going to take a look at how we can install Rudder agent to a Linux machine. So Rudder requires you to have a subscription, and based on the subscription you get extra functionalities. And since I have the free option chosen, I cannot use the Windows agent. So currently what we are going to do now at this moment is to have something like a Linux agent installed. So SSH CentOS D. Yeah, and that should be fine. So once we are in our CentOS, what we can do is as follows. So sudo vi, and we need to edit our yum repos d file. And if we add the Rudder repository here, then what we can do is to install our Rudder agent. So basically now what we need to issue after sudo su is the following command. So yum install Rudder agent. And this will install the agent that we would like to have in our Rudder environment. And after the agent was installed, what we need to do is to tell this agent that the root server is at a specific IP address or location, which is either by name resolve or whatever else that we have. So ping CentOS C. So we have the ping here. So now we can insert this command, which is available for you via the GitHub repository that I have provided. So now what we can do is to issue the Rudder agent start, and the Rudder has kind of interesting properties or inventories, so to speak. So if we go and log in to our admin interface, then what we can do is to go under the list nodes, and here we have this accept new nodes. So Rudder agent inventory so Rudder agent inventory. So now what we are doing is that we would like to send our inventory against the Rudder root server. So under here the accept nodes, now we will be able to see a new node which comes from the CentOS D. And here if we click on this part and then simply accept the new node, then what we will see under the list nodes is that we have two nodes. So one is the root server and the other is the Rudder agent. And we can see how much of a compliance. Oh, let me see. Bring it down here for you. So basically, if we click on the percentage bar, we will be able to select what kind of compliance that we would like to receive. So now what we can do under the list nodes is to inspect if the newly added node is compliant. If not, then we will have an error message. But if it is, then what we can do is to, let's say, include it in our rules and directives and techniques. So techniques are basically a set of instructions that you would like to execute on your nodes specified by the rules. The directives are a little bit different. So basically these are a predefined set of actions that you can perform on your Rudder environment. And basically you can use this to install a package, configure network, or whatever you feel like doing. And under the rules you can specify which directives and techniques should run on a group of hosts. So basically that's the idea behind Rudder. And in the next video we are going to continue our journey. See you in the next one.